I believe staff can make or break a child, and it takes everybody. Giving a pat on the back to a child, if they see a child that's upset, they ask them what's wrong, and they try to help them. Librarians, cafeteria staff encourage the kids to eat healthy, to eat well. Everybody, teachers in the classroom, you know, what your words matter. You know, you can encourage a child, you know, a child that maybe is not doing that well, you know, help them so that they don't give up. You don't want them giving up so young. It's critical. If our students are not disciplined, and it's two ways, in behavior, you know, learning and letting others learn, and also in sitting down and doing their work, having those study skills. Because when they go off to college and mom and dad aren't there, you know, did you do your homework? They have to discipline themselves. I need to get this work done by this time. So discipline is necessary not only in their behavior socially, but also, and in the classroom, but also when they're sitting down to do their work. And they might be intimidated a little, but I tell them, why can't you do it? Yes, it's gonna be hard work, but you can do it. And so they've put in that hard work. And when they do, they see success and it makes them feel good. There's a lot of people trying to help you. Principals, the counselors, I think everybody pitches in to try to help their students. So, and hopefully, you know, the teachers and the parents and the students form that relationship that helps that student. I know some are challenging. You know, parents are going through hard times or whatnot. A parent is ill, a parent is gone from the house, but when we work together, I think it just helps that child to get through those tough moments and hopefully make it. I look up to my mom, who overcame a lot of obstacles, you know, to succeed in life and to not to accept the words that others gave her, you're not good enough, you're nothing. And then she wanted us to do better. And she encouraged us and she supported us and she motivated us. So I look up to my mom. It's critical, because if a parent doesn't believe in education, that child is gonna pick up on it. And they don't have to use words, just their attitude. The parents are critical for the success of our students. When I see the parents of my students and they're pushing them, and that B is not good enough, I need, you know, you can do an A. Because parents know what their children are capable of. And when they push them and don't let them relax, you know, that child is gonna succeed. It's very humbling. It's very humbling. You work hard. I worked hard, very hard, and I know I have to work harder to do what I have to do. But I have my goals. I want my students to succeed. So I, you know, burn the midnight oil. So trying to find different ideas, different ways of doing things to make sure my students succeed. To me, faith, you have to have faith in yourself that you can do it. But to me, it's very critical, having a faith in God, you know, that spiritual side, that spiritual aspect, because that's what has helped me to keep going. Having that faith, and other staff around me have faith too, believe in God, and we help each other. You know, we encourage each other and we say we're gonna pray for each other. So to me, faith means a belief in God. You know, your spiritual aspect, your spirituality, and it needs to be nurtured. So it could be spiritual or just having faith in yourself. Don't give up. Believe in yourself. You can do anything that you set your mind to do. And it's, I think, an easier message with the younger ones because they haven't been told no or that's wrong. So with the little ones, they're still excited about learning. They're still engaged. They still have that wonder and awe when they learn something new. And so it gets a little harder, I think, with the older kids, because I have two high schoolers, two teenagers. And so just to get them to think, there's nothing you can't do. Don't give up. You try your best, you know, and as a parent or as a teacher, you tell them, make them focus on their strengths. And, you know, you have these strengths. Don't let your weaknesses hurt you. you know, we all have weaknesses, so we have to work harder at those things. And we don't give up.